You know, I think that the administration, and obviously I don't speak for them, have taken a look at the two situations, and they've made a determination that in the near and medium term that Iran is more problematic, even though the similarities or differences between the programs are very distinct and unique. North Korea is a today problem. It is not a tomorrow problem. Iran becomes a tomorrow problem. And whether or not the administration has taken a look at this, using the Gates metaphor, using the strategic patience adjectives and descriptions, and decided that maybe they can make some headway on Iran, whereas they cannot on North Korea. They put their energies towards Iran. But there is, in our opinion, a mistake here. The strategic patience, from my point of view, is an attitude, not a policy. Mm-hmm. And if you take, as we began to discuss, the question of the missile program, as Scott has indicated, you know, this is what the North Koreans, kind of the last phase of what they need to become a truly regional and perhaps a more global threat beyond proliferation. Well, when's the last time we've had a serious discussion with the North Koreans about their missile program?
End of the Clinton administration.
November 2000, almost 10 years. And what has happened in those 10 years? The North Koreans have proceeded with their research and development. They've had, in the last couple of years, additional tests to refine that capability. They're not there yet, but they're going to continue on that way. So unless we're engaging them across the board on all these issues on a today basis, an urgency basis, we're going to find that North Korea in tomorrow's threat is far greater than Iran.